Good evening to one and all those who are present here. So welcome back to Political Science class, session number 2 of the day. Okay, so in the morning session we discussed about election system in India. Election system in India. So different countries choosing different party systems. Okay, some countries follow single party system, some countries follow multi-party system, and our country is following, what is that? Multi-party system. And one more system is there, we know that is bi-party system, right? Okay, so different countries following this system related with the culture of that country, okay, social or regional division of that country, right? For a country like India, basically we want a multi-party system because one or two parties are unable to solve the issues in our country, basically speaking. So because it's a vast country, right or not? So one or two political parties are not enough to express the viewpoints of different sections of the people, because we have that many social divisions. Okay, that many communities are there, that many castes are there, that many religions are there. So one or two parties are not enough to express the viewpoint of the minorities and the majority. Okay, so we want the number of political parties in India. So we are using the multi-party system. Multi-party system. Clear? Okay. So you have a doubt why we are using this multi-party system? This is the answer. Clear? Different countries, as per their social and regional division, or their culture and heritage, or politics of the history. Okay. Sorry. Okay. What kind of history is that? History of politics, not politics of the history. History of the politics. Okay. That. Those things basically determine what system one to follow or what system one to choose. Clear? Okay, so come back. So India, basically we are following a multi-party system. Okay, and next one, what election method we are using to choose the candidate? In the morning session we discussed about the victory of the Congress party. Okay, victory of a Congress party in the year 1984. The Congress party came to power winning 415 out of 543 Lok Sabha seats. 543. What is the total number of Lok Sabha seats? So in junior classes, you mentioned about 545, right? Yes or no? Okay. So it is 543 plus 2. Two nominated members from the Anglo-Indian community by the president. Okay, nominated. There is no election for them, right? Okay, nomination by the president. Okay, so 543 plus 2 is equal to 545 as the total number of Lok Sabha. Clear? Let it be. Just understand that. Okay, so elected seats are 543. Clear? That many constituencies are there. Lok Sabha seats, more than 80% of the seats. So 450 means it is more than 80% of the total seats. Okay, it's a gigantic victory, a Herculean victory, right or not? Okay, or a Himalayan victory, we can say like that. Such a victory was never achieved by any party in Lok Sabha. What did this election show? So we already discussed that in the morning, right? Okay, what this show there? The people's attitude towards that particular political party. People's attitude towards that particular political party, right? So they like that party because that's a centrist party at that time, and came forward with the numerous programs for poverty alleviation and help the people. Okay, so basically people give their consent to that party to rule the country. The Congress party won 4/5 of the seats. Does it mean that 4 out of 5 Indian voters voted for the Congress party? Are you thinking like that? How many seats they got here? Okay, 4/5, which means, or that doesn't make a sense like that. Out of 5, 4 people, they give their consent to the Congress party. Okay, this don't have a meaning like that. There's no meaning like that. Clear or not? Okay, so they got nearly 4 portion out of 5. Clear? So here you can see, actually not. Take a look at the enclosed table. The Congress party got 48% of the votes only. Clear? 515 seats are there, but related with the voting share, Congress got only, what is that? 48%, less than 50, right or not? Right or not? all other party managed to secure 52% vote there. Clear. So basically speaking, so what is that? The people are against the Congress party, but the vote, it is splitted. The votes are splitted and went into different other political parties. As a result of that, the Congress party become the party that secured a majority of seats there. That system is basically, we discussed already, first past the post system. Okay, this means only 48 of those who voted in favor of the candidates put up by the Congress party, but the party still managed to win more than 80% of seats in the Lok Sabha. Look at the performance of other parties. The BJP got the 7.4% of votes, but less than 1% of seats. How did that happen? Okay, so BJP, they got nearly 7.4% of voter, but in the terms of seats, it is only 2. Clear or not? Okay, Congress party 48%, but in the case of seats, 415. Clear? So this percentage and the number of seats are not matching at all, right? No match. Okay. For example, 7 into 7. 49. Okay. Clear or not? Any doubt in that? 49 only, right or not? So at least how many seats they want to get as per this proportion? Minimum 49 seats necessary, right or not? But what they got here? Only 2 seats. So this is the problem with this system. Okay. Let it be. So Janata Party 6.7. But here the irony is they got 10 seats. Clear or not? Okay, not in the voting share, Janata Party's share of vote, percentage of vote, it is less than the BJP, but they managed to win in 10 constituencies. 10 seats are there. Clear or not? Okay, Lok Dal, their vote percentage 5.7 only, but 3 constituency. CPIM 5.7 only, but 22 seats are there. Okay, and the Telugu Desam Party 4.1, but 30 seats are there. DMK 2.3, 2 seats. Okay, ADMK 1.6%, 12 seats. Sir. Akali Dal 1%, 7 seats. AGP, okay, Assam Gana Parishad. That is 1% only, but 7 seats. Okay, so something missing there, right? Mathematically, some troubles are there. All right, this system is termed as what? First past the post system. Okay, first past the post system. So, as per this, clear or not? This is not a matter at all. The voting percentage. Clear? Seats are countable here. Okay, so come back. So a person votes but less than 1% of seats. How did this happen? This happened because in our country we follow a special method of election under this system. So learn this system. Okay, a special system. What this system? What is the system? The entire country is divided into 543 constituencies, right? Okay, each constituency elect one representative, right? Yes. Okay, and the candidate who secured the highest number of votes in that constituency is declared elected. Clear or not? The candidate who secured the highest number of votes from different constituencies are considering as, or they are considered as elected candidates. It is important to note that in this system, whoever has more votes than all other candidates is declared elected. Underline that. Whoever it is. There's no question. Okay, there's no question like that. Who received more number of votes compared with the other candidate, he or she is declared as elected. The winning candidate need not secure majority of the votes. Clear? There is no need of winning majority of votes. Okay, majority of the votes in the sense, what is that? What are the majority of votes? Okay,
more than half.
Okay, out of 1,501, it is considering as a majority, right? More than 50% plus. Clear or not? Clear or not? But in this case, first past the post system, I already told you, can we convert that into 400, 350, 250? One method, A, B, C. So A is the candidate who won that. Okay, coming to A, B, C, D, E, F. In multi-party system, this many parties are there. Just imagine. E, F. Okay. Okay. 200, 150, okay. So D go to 300, okay. So 500, 300, 800, okay. 100 and 100. So who is the winner here? out of these thousand votes, who is the winner?
D
is the winner then, because 300 votes are there, right? But just imagine, out of that 1700 people they are against, right? But the votes divided. So who become the winner? D became the winner here. Okay, this system is termed as what? First past the post. Okay, in multi-party system, think only A and B is there. Okay, 1000 voter. So here 501. Okay, 499. Who is the winner here? Who's the winner?
A.
A only. So clear majority is there. Anyway, the difference is just 2, right? Right? But a clear cut majority is there. Anyway, 2 people supporting this A than party B, right? So more supporters are there for that particular party. That is a satisfying matter there, basically speaking. So clear or not, more supporters are there. But in this case, impossible to find out. Okay, so only 300 supporters are there. Balanced people in that constituency, they are against that individual, or they are against that particular political party. Okay, come back here. Let us now go back to our example. Sorry. Okay, so majority of the votes. This method is called the first past the post, FPPP system. First past the post system. In the electoral race, the candidate who is ahead of others, who across the winning post first of all, it is the winner. Okay, in a race, you know that, right? A running race. Okay, sprint. Okay, the runner. Okay, or the sprint is in which who passed the post in the first position declared as the winner. Okay, or we will declare him as the or her as the winner, right? That system is what first past the post system. In the electoral race, the candidate who is ahead of others, who crossed the winning post first of all, is the winner. This method is also called plurality system. What the other name of FPTP? Plurality system. Plurality. Multiple parties are there. Multiple candidates are there. Okay. This is the method of election prescribed by the Indian Constitution. Clear? This is the method of election. Because the makers of the Indian Constitution, they are very much aware about the population and the growth of population, regional disparities, caste problems, religious problems in the country. So they decided we will follow this method in India. Okay, let us now go back to our example. The Congress party won greater share of seats than its share of votes, because in many of the constituencies in which its candidates won, they secured less than 50% of the votes. That's the reality, right? Number of constituencies, maybe the Congress party secured less than 50% of the vote, but balance votes, that's divided, clear or not, divided to number of other parties, so they manage to win that election. If there are several candidates, the winning candidate often gets much less than 50% of the votes. The votes that go to all the losing candidates go waste, clear or not? Okay, the vote that casted by the voters for other candidates is considering as what waste. So we wasted our right to vote, clear or not? Okay, that's it. Okay, so the votes that go to all losing candidates go waste, for those candidates or parties get no seat from these voters. Suppose a party gets only 25% of the votes in every constituency, but everyone else get even less votes. In that case, the party could win all the seats with only 25% votes or even less. Clear? The number of parties are there means this will happen. In a multi-party system, this is a common phenomenon, right? So please read up to here, 2 minutes. In this first past the post system, we know that it is divided into number of constituencies, that entire country divided into number of constituencies, right? Okay, and the people, those who living in one constituency, they are very much sure about their MLA or MP, right? They know them. Okay, perfectly they know them. Who is our MP and who is our MLA? There is no doubt in that. Whatever may be the party, that is another thing, right? But we are aware about the attitude of that particular individual. If we want any help, basically we can approach that particular individual from our constituency, right? MLA or MP, considering as the representative of that particular constituency. Okay, we can approach him easily. Clear? Yes or no? Is that possible or not? Are we able to approach these MLAs and MPs easily?
No, not sir. Sir.
That's it. Okay. So that is up to the mentality, attitude of those people there. Some are there always available for the people, but some people are there. We cannot find them. Basically, they are living in glass chambers. Okay, it is impossible to meet such kind of people there, right? Okay, very busy people it seems, sir. Okay, so let it be. But anyway, before next election, we can meet them. Okay, they will come to our home. Okay, so just keep that idea in your mind. So we are moving towards the next one, proportional representation. Proportional representation. But before that, you would understand, now there are number of phone numbers are there, so the assigned for the MLAs and MPs. If any troubles are there, we can call them. You can approach them. Okay, that's our right. Okay, individual right to approach the representative from our locality. Clear or not? So, phone numbers are there in the Kerala website. If you want, so you can download that and you can call them. Okay, and you can ask for number of things there. But what they will speak back, that is, what we can say, we cannot say anything like that. I mean, there is no, what you can say, positive attitudes related with that kind of a phone calls there so far. Okay, so might you can do that as a practice, as a political instrument. Okay, come back. Next one, proportional representation. Proportional representation, another method, the PR. Okay, example, out of 100 constituencies. Okay, clear or not? 100 constituencies. There are only two political parties are there. Both parties managed to win 50-50 percentage of votes. Okay, so 50 representatives from one party, balance 50 representatives from another party. Okay, basically party will participate in the election, not the candidates. Clear or not? Party will participate in the election, not the candidate. After the election, they will declare their representatives. Clear? Okay, a kind of system, a representative system. Okay, we will discuss that. Let us compare this to how elections take place in Israel, that follows a very different system of election. In Israel, once the votes are counted, each party is allotted the share of seats in the parliament in proportion to its share of votes. Clear? Clear? Okay, proportion to the votes that's secured by that particular political party. Okay, so total 100 votes, 10 seats are there, right? Which means 100 divided by 10, 1. For each 10 votes, 1 representative. Clear or not? Yes or no? Sorry, not 1, 10, right? Okay, 100 divided by 10, it is 10. Okay, so which means for 10 votes, how many representatives? 1 representative. Clear? Clear or not? So 10 votes, 1 representative. So for 10 seats, sorry, 100 votes, 10 representatives, right? 100 votes, 10 representatives, 10 votes, 1 representative. Is that clear now? That is clear now. Okay. So one party managed to get 25 votes. How many representatives will from that party? 2.5? No, not possible. Right or no? Okay. So they will use another method to do such kind of calculations. Okay, so each party fills its quota of seats by picking those many of its nominees from the preference list that has been declared before the election. So they will declare a panel of candidates. Clear or not? 10, 20, 30, like that. A panel will be there. After the election, they will choose the representatives from that panel. Clear? Basically, people casting their vote not for that, what you can say, particular candidates, but for the party. For the party. Anyway, the panel also important. Panel also important, right? Clear? Okay. This system of election is called the proportional representation or PR system. PR system. In this system, a party gets the same proportion of seats as its proportion of votes. Clear? Same proportion of votes as the proportion of seats there. So you can see here, name of lists. Parties, name the parties. Clear or not? Total votes and number of seats. Okay, as per the percentage. Clear? number of CCT total 120. 120. Clear? Is that clear or not? Okay.
Yes, sir.
So 120. So for liquid party, okay, they got 23.40. So how many percentage is 23.40? So they got 30 seats. 30 seats there. Okay. Clear or not? Yes or no? Is that clear or not?
Yes, sir.
Sionist camp 18.67. So got 24 seats. Clear? So 8% equal to 10 seats. Yes or no? Almost. Clear? Yes or no? Okay. So look at here. Yes, and join list. Number of parties together, they managed to get 10.61. So they got 13 seats. Yash Adit, they got 8.82%, 11 seats. Kulanu, 7.49, so 10 seats, almost 8. Clear. Habait, okay. Hayahudi, okay. They got 6.74, so 8 seats. Okay. Shas, 5.74, 7 seats. Israel, Bitinu, okay, 5.10, 6 seats. Okay, United, Thora, Judaisa, 4.99, 6 seats. So you can see here, 5.10, 4.99, 6 seats there. Okay, so the calculation is like that. Israeli left, 3.93, 5 seats. Other parties all together, 4.51, so no seats. Clear or not? Okay, so 120 done there. Okay, so your percentage of vote is decreasing, the number of seats also decreasing as per that. Observe that. Okay. The party got the more number of seats. So more percentage, more the seats. Less percentage, less the seats. Clear. But to come back to the Indian camp. What is here? What is here? Any relation is there? No relation at all. Okay. No relation at all. Okay. Here 7.4, only 2 seats are there. Okay. Only 1% is 7 seats are there. Okay. 48% is 15 is there. And for 4.1, 30 is there, right? Right? So total mismatching, right? Okay. So this is the difference between these two systems. These two systems. Okay. Which one is good for the country? What are you thinking? Which one is the system is good for the democracy? What is your answer? What is your answer? Is the first past the post system or proportional representation?
Tell so me. Both has its advantages and disadvantages. Definitely. Because okay. Israel is not as big of a country as India is.
Okay. So I already told you the answer in the beginning, right? Okay. So countries will choose the system as per their population, as per their social and religious division or regional divisions. Clear or not? For Israel, that is good because easy to count, easy to calculate, easy to share these votes there, right? But in India, we need centuries to conduct such kind of election like a PR system. Clear or not? Very troublesome one for India. Okay, so we used using the first past the post system. Both systems are good for that particular country related with the population, related with the history of the politics, related with the regional and social divisions. In the PR system, there could be two variations. In some countries, so there are two different types of PR systems are there. Okay, Israel system we discussed. Like Israel or Netherlands, the entire country is treated as one constituency. Okay. Israel and Netherlands, the entire country is considered as one single constituency. Clear or not? Okay. Next one. And seats are allocated to each party according to its share of votes in the national election. The other method is when the country is divided into several multi-member constituencies. Clear. As in Argentina and Portugal, they are following that system. Proportional representation only, but the country is divided into several constituencies. Okay. Each party prepares a list of candidates for each constituency, depending on how many have to be elected from that constituency. In both these variations, voters exercise their preference for party and not a candidate. Clear? Basically, in this system, PR system, the voters, they are casting their vote not for the candidate, but for the parties. But for the parties. But in India, what is the system? You already know that. the candidate matters. Candidate matters, right? Not only the party, the candidate and his caste, his religion. Okay, everything matters in India. Clear? Example, in one constituency, number of one particular religion is more, all the political parties will give preference for that particular candidate from that particular religion, right? Right? Okay, even the case of caste also, the same thing will happen. The same thing
Muslim League is...
Muslim League is basically become a majority party or a winning party in Malappuram, Kozhikode or Kasaragod. Because, what is the reason?
More Muslims.
Reason. In that region, that religion or the population of that particular religion is high compared with other religions. So they are able to win there. So any other candidate from other religion, he is contesting in the election means it will be difficult for him, right or not? Right or not? Okay. So some religious equations are there. Caste formulas are there for Indian politics, basically. So, okay. So those countries, foreign countries or Middle East countries, they are only wanted to find different political parties on the basis of ideologies. Clear or not? The religion is the same. No changes. But in India, not only the ideology, you want to think about the caste, you want to think about the religion, you want to think about the regions, then only we can choose a candidate. Clear? A candidate from Northern Kerala contesting in Southern Kerala, they will say that this person from Northern Kerala and he will not or he cannot do the activities here it seems. Okay. So such kind of things are there in Indian politics. Okay. Clear? Is that clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Fine. So the seats in a constituency are distributed on the basis of votes polled by the party. Thus, representatives from the constituency would and do belong to the different parties in India. We have adopted PR system. India also, we are using this PR system on a limited scale for indirect elections. Clear? The constitution prescribed a third and complex variation of PR system for the election of president, vice president, and for the election of Rajya Sabha and Vidhan Parishads. Okay. Legislative Council, LCs. MLC, okay, member of Legislative Council. MLA, member of Legislative Assembly, right? Okay, so in Kerala, bicameral system or unicameral system? You said about the bicameral system and the unicameral system, right? In the junior classes. What is bicameral system? Two houses of the parliament or the Legislative Council, right? Or legislative, two houses will be there. Clear or not? India, we are using bicameral system, Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha. Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha. Clear? And coming to Kerala, what system is that?
One system.
Unicameral. What is that? Unicameral. Only one level of the legislature. Okay, one level of the legislature. Okay. But some states are using bicameral system, where we are able to find a legislative council and legislative assembly. Okay, that's what. Vidhan Sabhas and Vidhan Parishads. Clear? Vidhan Sabhas and Vidhan Parishads. Assembly and council. Clear or not? Clear or not? Okay, so in India, we are using this system, the PR system, to choose the representatives for, what is that? Legislative Council, Vidhan Parishad and the Rajya Sabha, and it choose or elect the President and the Vice President. President and the Vice President. Clear? Indian PR system is a complex system, not like the first two systems there. Okay, we will discuss that. Now, we have a table here. Comparison of first past the post and the PR system of election. Very important question for the examination. Okay, first past the post system. First of all, we are reading that. The country is divided into small geographical units called constituencies or districts, right? In the first past the post system, the country will divide into small units termed as the constituencies or districts. Every constituency elect one representative, right? From every constituency, one representative will be there. Voters vote for the candidate, but not for the party. Okay, here candidate matters. Okay, party also important, but most preference for the candidate. This point, a party may get more seats than votes in the legislature. Clear? A party may get more seats than votes in the legislature. Okay, I already told you that, right? Waste votes are there. Many political parties are there. Is what will happen there? This party, some one party will manage it to win. All other parties will share the balance vote, and that considering as a waste vote there. Next one, candidates who win an election may not get majority okay, anyway, not more than 50 percentage plus one, no chance for that. Okay, clear or not? But sometimes we'll get also clear, but you're not sure about that. Okay, if a good candidate, okay, other candidates are not that good, not that good in the sense of not personally, okay, in his philosophy or in his activities, okay, if you're not good, one candidate can win more than 50% of vote. Chances are there. Question PR system. Large geographical areas are demarcated as constituencies. The entire country may be a single constituency. Okay, large areas considering as a constituency. In the case of first past the post system, single small areas are there. Okay, clear. More than one representative may be elected from one constituency. Voters vote for the party. Okay, clear. In case of first past the post, only one candidate from one constituency. In case of PR system, more than one candidates. Oh, sorry, representatives. Okay, clear or not? And the same time, voters vote not for the candidate but for the party. But for the party. Next one, every party gets seats in the legislature in proportion to the percentage of votes that it gets. Every party will get the seats there, right? Chances are there for all the parties to get represented to you in that legislature. Okay, but in the system, first past the post system, no chance for that. Clear. A candidate who wins the election get majority of votes there. Okay, anyway, 50% plus vote will be there for the winning candidates. Example, Israel, Netherlands. First past the post system, UK, India. UK and India. Okay, 2 minutes for you people to read all these things there. Okay, come. Okay. Next topic for us is, why did India adopt the first past the post system? The answer is not very difficult to guess. If you have carefully read the books explaining the Rajya Sabha election, you would have noticed that it is a complicated system which make work in a small country, right? So by observing itself, we can see that a formula is there, mathematical formula is there. Okay, but it is not applicable for a country like India because the population is too high. Okay, the reason for the popularity and success of the first past the post system is its simplicity, right? Simply we are able to, but it is not an accurate system, but it is simple system. Clear? Not the correct system or not the perfect system, but it is a simple system in my opinion. Okay, the entire election system is extremely simple to understand even for common voters who may have no specialized knowledge about politics and election. So the first past the post system, we are able to explain to illiterate persons also. Easily they are able to understand that. And what about this PR system in the Rajya Sabha election? Is that possible to explain for a illiterate one? Or she is able to understand the system? Impossible. But is the correct method speaking so? Okay, only educated people can understand that. There is also a clear choice presented to the voters at the time of election. So in the case of first past the post system, there's a clear-cut idea is there for the voters, for who want to cast the votes. Voters have to simply endorse a candidate or a party while voting. Simply, they can think about a particular candidate or a particular political party before the voting, right? Depending on the nature of actual politics, voters may either give greater importance to the party or to the candidate or balance the two. The first past the post system offers voters a choice not simply between parties but specific candidates. In other electoral system, especially in PR system, voters are often asked to choose party and the representatives are elected on the basis of party list. Okay, so in this system, first past the post system, voters have two choices. One is it is related with the candidate, the other is it is related with the party. Clear? Clear or not? They can choose the party or the candidate. Clear? Two methods are there. Okay, but in the representative system, proportional representative system, the people are basically giving their consent to that particular party, right? They don't know who is their candidate or who will become the representative of their region. They don't know that. Okay, clear? There is no representative who represent and it is responsible for one locality. In a constituency based system like the FPTP, the voters know who their own representative is and can hold him or her accountable. Clear? Clear? Which means in the system, in Indian system, we know our candidate, we know our MLA or MP, okay, and he or she is responsible for the problems in that constituency, he or she want to solve that. Clear? Definitely we can approach them, right? Clear? Okay, but in that proportional representative system, there is no such kind of, responsibility. Clear? is the responsibility of the party or the government, not for that single candidate or that representative. Clear? Understand? Okay. Hope these things are clear for you people. So please read and understand and work out this. One day is there for you people. Okay, please work out this and give me an explanation in the next class. Clear?
Okay. Yes, sir.
So you have to explain it. I will give chances for you as considering as a seminar for you people. Okay. So everyone be prepared. Okay. Thank you. We'll meet in the next session.